Welcome to BrainStuff. You stink. I mean, so do I. Don't be offended. Everybody smells. That's just a fact of life. And today's question is, can a disease change the way you smell? The answer is yes. Not only can a disease change the way you smell, but different diseases can cause different smells. And when we say diseases, we're not just talking about physical ailments. It is also possible to detect a mental illness through smell. And this is not really deserving of a spoiler alert because our species has known about it for thousands of years. Even Hippocrates apparently used smell as a diagnostic tool when he would sniff the breath and urine of people to see if there was some sort of ailment going on in their body. So let's talk about how diseases change the way a person smells. The smell from a disease will emanate from your breath, your blood, your urine, your sweat. And there's a culprit at play here, a chemical. The chemicals known as volatile organic compounds, or VOCs for those in the know, influence the way these smells emanate. A disease cell metabolizes in a different way than a healthy one, and this is what makes something rotten in the state of Denmark, if you know, like Denmark is your body. Experts believe that this smelling disease capability is an evolutionary adaptation, that we, the human species, have evolved to sense an ailment from another member of our species, and that it gives us, you know, a heads up so that we can stay away from them and prevent the spread of disease. This may also be why certain scents are just so repellent and repugnant and disgusting to people, because on some level we associate them with disease. Now here's the $1 billion or billion plague question, I guess. What do diseases smell like? And that means it's time for our handy list of plague smells. So next question, who can actually smell this stuff? Can people smell it? A lady in Scotland lost her husband to Parkinson's disease, and over the progression of his condition, she noticed that his scent was changing. It was becoming increasingly musky. Scientists at Edinburgh University decided to put this to the test, and they asked her to identify Parkinson's based on smell alone. They were astounded when, out of the 12 people she identified with Parkinson's, she got 11 correct. I mean, that's an incredibly high success rate. And they went from astounded to astonished when number 12 began exhibiting Parkinson's symptoms 8 months later. That's a 100% success rate. But of course, humans are not the only players in the game of smelling disease. Dogs are actually way better at it because, you know, your pooches treat scents the way that we humans treat sight. Scent is their primary source of encountering the world. And what we have found is that dogs do have an ability to smell certain odors and associate them with certain ailments. Certain service dogs have been trained to detect blood sugar fluctuations in their owners and then alert them before a seizure or some adverse medical condition occurs. An even more fascinating fact here is that dogs are especially good at sensing prostate cancer. At the High Wycombe Hospital, several studies conducted indicated that dogs did have this ability, and when they focused on prostate cancer, they found something amazing. Out of 900 samples, the dogs identified the condition correctly 98% of the time, and furthermore, the control group included people who had cancer, but not prostate cancer. And these dogs were able to tell the difference. And this brings us to the forefront of modern research. Is it possible for humanity to build some sort of machine that can mimic these same processes that we see happening in a dog's extraordinary olfactory sense? And the answer is, we're on the way. Consider there's a small pocket radio sized device called Cyrano's. Get it? Like Cyrano, Bergerac? There's a movie. This pocket radio-sized device is able to take in gas and analyze it, searching for certain VOCs, and from there, diagnosing a condition. Right now, its range is pretty limited. It can sense pneumonia or sinusitis and other similar related things, but we're hoping that this kind of device will expand both in the number of VOCs that it is able to sense, its sophistication when it comes to diagnosing, and as a consequence, its ability to save lives. So that's where we're at now. I don't wanna WebMD you guys or scare anybody with disease, but if you wanna rewind and check the smells for each disease, feel free. And of course, as always, if you think that there's something smelling rotten, then do check with a medical professional. In the meantime, have you ever smelled a disease before? Do you think you're capable of doing it? If so, what and how did it smell? Let me know in the comments, and as always, stay tuned for more Brain Stuff.